In 2011, Novak Djokovic volleyed a tennis ball on the wing of an airplane, so I decided to try to replicate his results. My name is Ray Smith, and this is my wing walking experience. Before going up on an actual plane, I decided to try something a little bit less complicated.
Going up to Mount Woodson with a ball machine. Believe it or not, to volley on potato chip rock. This should be fun.
To get a feeling of volleying on the wing of an actual plane, I did the best I could. I just got on this big rock, and I didn't get out there too far because it's probably a deadly thing to do. So anyway, I was up there volleying because I had seen Djokovic do this in his head racket commercial in 2011, and then Mythbusters tried to disprove it, and they couldn't disprove it. So I thought, well, maybe it's possible. So I decided I would try something similar, so I got up on Potato Chip Rock. I also signed up for a wing walking course with West Coast Spin Doctors in Sequim, Washington. So after practicing all of these volleys, including on the stationary plane with no motor going, it was time. I practiced all morning. I was kind of excited, a little bit nervous, but ready to try the wing walking experience. So when it was time to climb up onto the wing, I made sure the pilot knew I was going to do that. He gave me a thumbs up, I think. Anyway, I clambered up and got my left foot up and then my right foot directly behind me, but in front of the pilot's windshield, avoiding breaking it. So with the wind blowing in my face, I worked my way up onto the wing. I grabbed a cable, grabbed a post, I was up there. I tried not to look down, and I was ready for a ride. We were doing a loop, which was a lot like Magic Mountain, but a little more extreme. When you get upside down, hanging from a seatbelt, and suddenly your feet seem to not be wanting to stay above you, it's a little bit different. When you look at the clouds below you, you begin to get a different feeling. Suddenly you realize you are actually doing loops. Needless to say, I left that tennis racket behind because I knew that the 60-mile-an-hour wind would be too much for me to even hit volleys with a ball that's tethered to my racket strings. We swooped down to land, and it was a great feeling to be on the ground, but to know also that I had actually wingwalked. It was unlike anything I've ever done.
Recommend it to anybody who's wanting to have a fun time up high in the sky.